questions, please?
Bob, difference between the first 30 minutes, when you guys were up by 12, and then all of a sudden you got away from me, what changed?
Well, we're supposed to double anything on the top. This is the last, their last basket of the first half. We're up, whatever, we're up 15, 16. And we don't double it. We stand back in the lane, let him come off with a clean look. He makes a three, which I thought kind of gave a little on that. But to answer your question, they just don't tell us. They just wanted it more than we did.
You guys didn't score. Was that the toughest aspect that you could be in your offense?
Yeah, I mean, you know, you go over there, you got to get it entered first. So you spend whatever time you got to spend to get it entered, and then you can't get it reversed because the guy who was supposed to pop out to get it reversed can't get over it. And the guy, when you reverse it over on the way, I mean, we had that. So we don't pass the ball.
Speak to why somebody makes a 3-point shots?
I think all those 3-point shots, Bob, honestly, is a lack of toughness.
A lack of
toughness. I mean, a lack of that's an easy way out. You get a little pressure, and so you start throwing your leg out, kicking your leg out, and shooting threes. We're switching, you know, that so they switch. So we screen a guy, the other guy comes off, they switch it. Big deal. So they switch it. So the guy screening is between the basket, his man in the basket, which he's open. We never one time looked at him, and that's after every timeout, saying, okay, when we run the flex cut, you have to look at the screener. Don't worry about the guy coming off. Look at the screener. I tried to simplify it as best. Really, you're supposed to look at the cutter, and then you're supposed to look at the screener. But I was like, yeah, they're switching everything. Just look at the screener, can we? Just please look at the screener. We never did. Never did. Then we said, then they're yelling at me, let's run smash cut. I'm like, oh, hell, I mean, nothing else worked. We run smash cut. JC is cut, comes out of smash cut. He's wide open. Wide open. I mean, I heard the people behind the bench yelling, you know. They knew he was open. Everybody knew he was open, but the guy would fall. Or if he knew he was open, he didn't want to throw it to him. I'm not sure. You know, sometimes that happens. I don't think that happens with these guys. But.
Coach, under 7 minutes in the second half, they had three kind of big threes for them in the corner. A result of, like, what they were running or just miscommunications or combination?
People not doing their job. People not doing their job. We gave Mikhailov a three in the corner in the first half. And I took the guy out, and we had a timeout, and I said, please explain to me what you don't understand about stay with him. Do not give him an open look in the corner. Tell me what you don't understand about that. We go in, we talk about it at halftime, and they come out and leave him. I don't know what would possess you to do that. I wish I knew. I don't know. We just left him wide open.
Offensively, when things started breaking down,
JC had the ball too much, but I mean, he had the ball too much because nobody else could get open.
You feel like Texas Tech and here, both people were expecting him to do something rather than what they were supposed to be doing?
Texas Tech didn't take as much away as what they did tonight. We passed the ball against Tech. I mean, we didn't move the ball against Texas Tech. I just said downstairs there, you know, our game is about this. You know, you either throw it to the bad guys and you reverse it to the good guys. Because everybody's got guys that aren't near as good, and we're loving them. And or you throw it to the good guys, you have the bad guys screen for them, and you run them to the ball so that you switch sides of the floor and you get a little bit of movement before, and that's basketball. Or you take it and you have somebody who can beat people off the bounce and create. It's hard to create when they don't respect anybody to make a shot. I mean, we had shots. Beadle had shots. We depend on Beadle to make shots. He didn't make any. Lamont had open shots. They weren't forced shots. I honestly thought we came down and we threw the ball to one of our forwards on a wing who should never had the ball on the wing. Never. And we threw it to him anyways. I had been, and our guard that had the ball has been told, don't throw it to him now. He's going to do something stupid with it. He did. He threw it away. And then we got him on the same side, and we throw it to him. He don't not even looking for it, and it hit him in the head. Didn't quite hit him in the head, but would have been, and got his hand up, and we lose it there. I mean, I can't explain why when you're told don't do that, they do it. And then we got Lamont. Lamont's running down the wing like he's running down the sideline like he's supposed to run down the sideline, and we make a back shoulder throw. There wasn't any defense on him. You know? I mean, we got a guy on a fly pattern, and we're trying to make a back shoulder throw to a guy who, you know, he's not going to catch it. Why? I have no idea why. It's almost like, you know, sometimes we want to get it out of our hands. And then our pressure sucked. Terrible. Today, had two turnovers in the second half. Because we don't press them. And that happened to Texas Tech. That's been a pattern. Maybe we're playing guys too long. But, I mean, the guys I play too long really are my seniors. And, you know, you should be able to count on those guys. We take the press off. I mean, nobody else does. Our guys take it off. And that's, you know, you go in, you talk about what you're going to do offensively, you talk about what you're going to do defensively, and defensively, all we talked about every time out was what we're going to do with our pressure. And there wasn't any. No, we still got it. You know, if you wanted to play, I'm sorry, but if you want to play and you're told the guy's going to drive right, don't let him drive right, you probably shouldn't let him drive right. We constantly let them go where they want to go. That's bad basketball. We did a better job in the first half. We did a better job in the first half. Why we didn't do it in the second half, I have absolutely no idea. I think this. You ever heard the analogy of a guy playing golf and, you know, he's like a 90, you know, shoots 90 most of the time. And so he goes out and he shoots 37 on the front. What's he say? This ain't like me. Man, I don't know what this is today, but this ain't like me. And he goes out and he shoots a 59 on the back, and he says, "I see, I told you. This is more like me." Because he's comfortable. He's comfortable shooting a 59. He's not comfortable shooting a 37. We probably weren't very comfortable being number two in the country. I told him in practice just the other day, I said, "Look up at that crow's nest up there. What do you think about that?" So, it's pretty high. Yeah, well, that's kind of where you are. You're one rung away from the top. It's not so hard to climb up there. Boy, that fall's a bitch. That fall is hard. And that's about what I told him, that's about what we're getting ready to do. Our preparation wasn't what it needed to be.
Well, if Teddy doesn't play, he's not happy
with
what he's practicing
with. No, we're not happy with his attitude.
Bob, not to put words in your mouth, but things you said today have kind of overlapped with things you said the past few games about attitude, toughness, not playing guys who clearly have been warned, I would imagine. Short term, I understand, it's 48 hours, but a lot changed. What long term issues do you foresee?
I tell you what, I'd be a hell of a coach if I knew the answer to that. I don't know. That's that old adage about leading a horse to water, but you can't make him drink. It's not like we haven't talked about it. It's not like we haven't looked at it on film. It's not like we haven't drilled it. It's not like we haven't practiced it. We have. I mean, the reality is we're up 11 at Tech, and we're up whatever we were up today, 12 or whatever it was. They out-toughed us.